Human immunodeficiency virus, commonly known as HIV. In this week's video, we're gonna go through everything that you need to know about HIV. Now, this video is gonna be jam-packed, full of scientifically supported information, and to make it a bit easier to digest, I've split the videos into two episodes. So this is episode one. We're gonna first talk about what is HIV, how is it spread, where and how to get tested, and what to do if you think you've been exposed to HIV. In the next episode, so episode two, we're gonna be talking about living with HIV and life expectancy, how to have children if you're HIV positive, and also the complications of HIV. So there's lots to learn, so let's begin. Okay, so first of all, what is HIV? HIV is a virus that affects our immune system. It makes our immune system weaker, and this means that it's harder for our bodies to fight off infections and any foreign bodies that infect our body. After this happens, it also then reduces our CD4 count, and CD4 is a certain type of white blood cell which then decreases, which again reduces our immune system. So when someone is first infected with HIV, they might have a short illness for about 1 to 2 weeks, okay? Having general sort of flu-type symptoms, okay? That's the best way to explain it. Flu-type symptoms for 1 to 2 weeks. And these symptoms usually come about after 6 to 8 weeks. After you've got rid of those flu-type symptoms, you don't experience symptoms for many years. Now, the virus will be causing internal damage to the immune system, okay? And the worrying thing is, you're not really gonna know this is happening unless you have a HIV test to show that you've got HIV. So it's gonna be happening in the background without you knowing, unless you're being tested. And I guess another thing to be aware of as well is that you could be spreading it to people without even knowing it, unless you're being tested. So that's kind of what's happening in the background. Now, when it comes to AIDS, it's not the same thing as HIV, okay? AIDS stands for Acquired Immune Deficiency Syndrome, and it's the way to describe how the body reacts to various life-threatening infections and illnesses that can occur due to HIV reducing the immune system massively. So if you're again wondering what is the difference between HIV and AIDS, HIV is the virus that affects our immune system and it lowers the immune system and weakens it, whereas AIDS is the way of describing the actual end result and the life-threatening infections that can happen due to that immune system being so weak. Okay, so next up, let's talk a little about statistics. So, in 2019, the National AIDS Trust here in the UK estimated around 105,000 people here in the UK are living with AIDS. Now, please bear in mind, that was from about 3 years ago, so the numbers probably have gone up. Also, there are a number of people who are undiagnosed as well, so the number will probably be much higher than this as well. So the next question is, how is HIV spread? HIV is found in certain bodily fluids, such as blood, semen, breast milk, vaginal and anal fluids. It can't be passed via urine, via saliva, or via sweat. The most common way that HIV is spread is through unprotected sex, but that is not the only way that it's spread either. So for example, a pregnant person with HIV can spread the HIV to their child during birth, during pregnancy, or during breastfeeding. HIV can also be spread with shared needle use, okay? Shared needle use, that can spread HIV. But HIV cannot be spread through things like sharing toilet seats, using the same toilet seat after someone that's got HIV, eating food, and also sharing liquids or drinks or anything like that. So it can't be spread through that. That is a sort of myth. Okay, so now let's move on to testing. If you do think you might have HIV or you think you might have had symptoms or anything like that, then you should get tested. I am gonna talk a bit later on as well about what to do is if you've actually been exposed to HIV. So if you know you've been exposed to HIV, the protocol is slightly different because you need treatment straight away. But for now, in terms of testing, testing is available and it's just done via a blood test. And if you do get a positive test for HIV, it's usually repeated. And once you get a second confirmation that you are HIV positive, you will be referred to the specialist who deals with patients with HIV and looks after them patients. Now, please do remember, if your first test was negative, you may need a repeat test 1 to 3 months after first exposure. This is known as the window period, and the HIV hasn't affected you enough, or the cells haven't replicated enough either, the virus hasn't replicated enough for it to be detectable. So sometimes a repeat test is done. Now, here in the UK, all sexual health clinics do offer HIV tests free of charge. I'm sorry I'm standing you up, it's just my legs are getting very tired because I've been running, but all sexual health clinics here in the UK do offer it free of charge, and there is no charge needed for it, and it can be done straight away. There are also home testing kits that you can use if you don't want to go into clinic, where you have to send off a sample of blood, usually sort of got from the finger through milking of the finger and having a small sample and sending it off. Or you can just go to the sexual health clinic and get it done there and then. I don't know what it's like in other countries, so please follow your healthcare guidance on this to find out where and what you need to do to get tested. And please do remember that the sooner that you get tested, the more likely you are to find out what's going on and also reduce the risk of actually spreading it to other people, to loved ones or anyone like that. Also, the sooner you find out as well, you could then start treatment sooner as well. So it's really important that testing is done. Now, please do remember, this is probably one of the most important things when it comes to HIV. If you think you've been exposed to HIV, you need to speak to your healthcare team as soon as possible, okay? Because there is something known as post-exposure prophylaxis, okay? And it's a treatment, it's a short course given, which helps stop HIV from getting in your system and replicating and then actually having HIV, okay? This tablet or this medication, there's a few medicines you have to take. It should be taken within 72 hours of exposure, okay? If it's taken after that window, it's not gonna work. So it's super critical. If you think you've been exposed, get in touch with your healthcare professional, get in touch with your sexual health clinic. I will leave more information about that down in the description below and where to find that information from and get that help from here in the UK. Like I said again, I don't know what it's like in other countries, but post-exposure prophylaxis is probably available in all countries, where it's important that you're aware of it. And remember, the window is 72 hours. If you think you've been exposed, you should get post-exposure prophylaxis. So it looks like we've come to the end of episode one. Like I said at the start, please make sure to watch episode two as well, because there's still loads more to learn. As I always say, sending you awesome vibes, and I will see you next week.